Aisha! Aisha!
I suppose, oh, look at him.
Well, we're here today obviously to support civil liberties and the right of people to take photographs. As you can see from the placard there, Jean-Luc Godard said photography is truth, and I think we wouldn't know the truth of many things that are happening in this world if it wasn't for very brave and committed photographers. And Kevin and I both work for George Galloway, and he's very, very keen that we should be here today and say obviously photography is not terrorism either. It's a necessity in our society to show the truth. He is very supportive of everybody that's here today. He has a radio show on Friday and Saturday nights on Talk Sport. And the two women the European Court of Human Rights on one, when they were arrested under the Prevention of Terrorism Act, when they were taking photographs at the protests against the arms fair at the Excel Centre. He interviewed them and got a very, very good response from all the people that were listening, the millions of people that were listening around the world. So this is a campaign he's very committed to, and he will be, and all of his staff will be committed to supporting every photographer here.
I'm also a member of the National Union of Journalists, and this is a critical campaign for media freedom and the freedom of news gatherers in general, because there's photographers being harassed, both professional and people who are simply taking pictures around London. There are also other news gatherers being harassed. There's been an increase in the number of times that journalists in print, print journalists have been stopped, have been prevented from interviewing people. And there appears to be an attitude encouraged by the government, going all the way down to the rank and file police officer, which is that it's their role to prevent people from taking pictures or from gathering news. Now, this is not their role. This is not even enshrined in law. The law itself is bad enough, but they're overstepping the boundaries of even a draconian law. And this is a major concern. I think a lot of people don't really realise it's happening until you get what's happening increasingly in London, which is tourists, both from international tourists and domestic tourists to London, taking pictures of buildings and suddenly finding that they're not allowed to do so, particularly down on the embankment down on Millbank near the MI5 headquarters. Just a few weeks ago, I was wandering past there and saw two young Malaysian tourists who were simply taking pictures stopped because it was by the MI5 headquarters, which is completely ridiculous given that Google Earth exists these days.
Absolutely. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.